confess tomorrow because of you. All fear is gone because I know He holds my future, and life is worth the living just because He lives.
Because He lives, I can face tomorrow.
He lives.
Because He lives, all fear is gone.
And life is worth the living just because He lives. Because He lives.
Because He lives.
Oh,
I can face tomorrow.
Because He lives.
All fear is gone.
All fear is gone.
Because I know.
Said it is finished. And today we can declare with confidence that we serve a living God, that our God is alive, that our God is here with us, that our God is victorious, and Lord, our Redeemer lives. Lord, we want to commit this service into your able hands, to pray that you will begin with us from the beginning to the end, to pray that you will speak to us, to pray that you will encourage us, that Lord, you will lift us, that Lord, you will rebuke us, that Lord, whatever it is you want to do with us today, that you will do in this service, Lord. We commit every aspect into your able hands. Would you bless us in Jesus' name? Amen. Good morning. Now, I know you're watching us from various places, and we just want to say karibu sana. If you're courageous enough, tusimame where you are, because we want to praise our God and we want to say that our Redeemer lives. We welcome you to this service today. We pray that you'll be blessed, that God will speak to you, that God will encourage you. Tusimame pamoja, Bwana Gideon, as you lead us in praise.
Thank you very much. Karibuni sana. Want to sing praises unto Jesus. Amen.
Moyo wangu sifu Bwana, sifu Bwana. Siku zote, hallelujah, hallelujah.
milele atawale milele atawale milele atawale milele pigieni Bwana vigelegele vigelegele kwa furaha Pigieni Bwana vigelegele vigelegele kwa furaha Ameniokoa, amenikomboa, akanibariki, akaniinua. Ameniokoa, amenikomboa, akanibariki, akaniinua. Shangwe, shangwe na nderemo. Tende, tende. Pigieni Bwana vigelegele vigelegele kwa furaha Pigieni Bwana vigelegele vigelegele kwa furaha Ameniokoa amenikomboa akanibariki akaniinua Ameniokoa amenikomboa akanibariki akaniinua baba tunakusifu leo baba tunakusifu leo baba let's shout Jesus amen amen lango ndiye Yesu Bwana amen
amen
amen Lango ndiye Yesu Bwana wote waingie kwake Lango 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 la mbinguni ni wazi Lango ndiye Yesu Bwana wote waingie kwake Hallelujah, ni Yesu. Lango, lango ni
Yesu. Ote wa iye pate. Lango, 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 lango.
Liko lango.
Liko lango moja wazi ni lango la mbinguni na wote waingia watapata nafasi
liko lango
liko lango moja wazi
ni lango Lango la mbinguni Na wote wapitia Watapata nafasi Lango, lango
Lango, lango
Tazama, ishi sasa, kuhu
Yesu. Nina mwenyewe, haleluya, utaishi ukitazama, tazama, ishi sasa, kumtazama Yesu. Amenena. Tazama, tazama,
ishi sasa,
tazama
Yesu,
amenena,
amenena mwenyewe,
haleluya,
ishi tazama,
amenena,
amenena mwenyewe,
his words. And as we sing this song that says he's a wonderful, he's a counselor, and he's everything to us. I pray that as we do this, as we even mentioned the various prayer requests that you have at home, I pray that God would answer you according to your riches in glory.
So close now on a highway through the darkness night. Would you hold my hand, Jesus? Guide my way. Though you walk with me and you dine with me, for my heart of heart is bound to you.
Though I walk through valleys low, I feel
so our soul pants after you. We run to you, O desire of nations. May you be our desire today. May you be that which we seek this morning, O God. We do not look to anybody else, but we look to you because you are faithful. We put our trust in you because there is none like you, O God. I want to bless you that in our darkest, you are our light. That, my Father, you are the light to our feet. So, Lord, we pray that even as we continue to seek your face, would we find you. We bless you that you have been with us this far. You have been Ebenezer through our difficulties. You have been Ebenezer through our hardest times. And I want to pray, would you continue to stay faithful to us, O God. I bless you that as a nation you have watched over us. And my Father, we pray in the name of Jesus, would you continue to have your shadow over our nation. We want to pray and continually come against this disease that has come to our nation and to our world. We have trusted in you, my Father, that our answer is on the way. And anything that the enemy has planned against us, we rebuke in the name of Jesus. And we declare that we are victorious because we have you on our side. I want to bless you because I know that, my Father, you are with us. That when we trust in you, you're able to do beyond what we can ask or imagine. So I want to pray, Heavenly Father, would you come through for us? Would you show yourself as a mighty God? I bless you for our president. I bless you for his deputy. I want to bless you for our county government. I thank you for our governor and his deputy. I want to pray for our MPs. I want to pray for our MCAs. My Father, would you guide our leaders that as they make decisions in this difficult time, may those decisions be guided by you. Would you take the heart of our king, and my Father, would you direct it? We pray for our bishop and his assistant and the administrative secretary and the whole leadership of AGC. We want to thank you for the body of Christ wherever we are gathered today. I want to pray that may your word come forth with power, that even as we use this technology, Jehovah, would you touch the hearts of your people. Now, Lord, you know every desire that your children have this morning. I present it before you because, Lord, on the cross of Calvary, you said it was finished. And my Father, our diseases are finished. My Father, our poverty is finished when we look to you. Now give us the strength to do what we must, to serve you and to do your work. Now, Lord, we honor you because we know when we call, even before we call, you have heard and you have answered. For it's in Jesus' name we have prayed and believed. Amen. Amen. Thank you. We continue to welcome you to our service this morning. We are glad that you are watching. Now we are going to go to our time of giving. And if you want to give your tithe or your offering, remember it's 830-550. That is our pay bill number. And you can indicate tithe or offering or thanksgiving, whatever it is that you want to do today as we sing for the Lord this morning.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Aliyeniita ni mwaminifu kweli, ni mwenye haki Baba yetu, yeye akiahidi atatimiza, akiahidi atatimiza.
Aliyeniita ni mwaminifu kweli,
ni mwenye haki
Baba yetu, yeye
aliyeniita
ni mwaminifu kweli,
ni mwenye haki
Baba yetu, yeye
akiahidi atatimiza,
akiahidi
atatimiza,
atatimiza.
Haleluya, Mungu si mkalimu ili adanganye, tena ni mwaminifu, hawezi sema uongo. Amini, amini, ni mwenye haki, hakika, hakika, atatimiza. Mungu si mkalimu ili adanganye, tena si mwanadamu ili aseme uongo. Amini, amini, ni mwenye haki, hakika, hakika.
Ni mwenye haki ni Baba yetu, yeye aliyeniita ni mwaminifu kweli,
ni mwenye haki,
ni mwenye haki ni Baba yetu, yeye
akiahidi,
akiahidi
atatimiza,
atatimiza, akiahidi
atatimiza. Aseme uongo. Mungu si mkalimu ili ajute, tena si mwanadamu ili adanganye. Akiahidi atatimiza. Amini, amini, ni mwenye haki, hakika, hakika atatimiza. Amini,
amini, amini, amini. Mwenye haki, hakika, hakika,
hakika,
atatimiza. Amini, amini,
amini, ndugu
yangu. Mwenye haki, hakika, hakika, atatimiza. Amini, amini,
haleluya.
Mwenye haki, hakika, hakika,
atatimiza.
Aliyeniita ni mwaminifu kweli.
Mwenye haki,
mwenye haki ni Baba yetu, yeye
aliyeniita,
aliyeniita,
aliyekuita ndugu yangu. Mwenye haki,
mwenye haki ni Baba yetu,
akiahidi,
akiahidi
atatimiza,
atatimiza,
akiahidi Yesu,
akiahidi
atatimiza,
atatimiza,
akiahidi Baba,
akiahidi
atatimiza,
atatimiza,
atatimiza. Atatimiza,
atatimiza,
atatimiza.
Indeed, he who called us is faithful. And when he promises, he fulfills his promises. Shall we pray for our offering and also pray for our pastor, Benjamin, as he brings the word of the Lord to us this morning. Lord, we thank you that you are true and you're faithful. And your promises are yes and amen in Jesus Christ. And when you promise, you fulfill. And Lord, we thank you that you have said in your word that the just shall live by faith. That even in these difficult times, we shall live by faith. Thank you for the offering that we have given today. Would you receive it, O God? And would you give us a good return? May we not lack because we have given. Receive our offering, we ask. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Allow me to welcome our pastor, Benjamin Ronald, to bring the word of the Lord to us this morning. And as he comes, shall we pray for him? Father, we are grateful for the power of your word. And as your servant comes to bring your word, I want to pray that would you anoint him and give him the tongue of the learned. May your word come forth to us with power and with clarity. For it's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Buona sifiwe, our viewers at home, our listeners over Radio Njili. We thank God for you today. And we want to praise the Lord together. And I hope mko sawa nyumbani, kila mtu mko poa home. And this is a funny time where I think everyone can answer the question, habari ya nyumbani vizuri, because all of us have been home. And I would say for the first time, we've been home the longest. And it's been a good experience to most of us. Some of us are still struggling with the experience, but we thank God for each and everything that we are going through, because indeed he said, give thanks to God in everything. Buona sifiwe. So sit at home, follow us, listen to the sermon, and we know that God will bless all of us. And this is a time for us in our nation, in the whole world. And the whole nations, the whole world, they are deep in prayer, praying to God. And I had a sermon last week, about during the death of Jesus Christ and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Then there were two women who went to check on the grave because they had an assignment to do. Now they had a question, and the question was, who will roll the stone for us? And I know we've had that sermon, and we've been told who will roll the stone for us. But today I have one question that I would like us to follow. Because in our nation, God has been with us. God has blessed us. And apparently, this pandemic is a bit, I would say, softer on us, because we can see other nations, people are dying every day. And God has been faithful to us. But today, I have a question that I would like to ask. But there's one thing and one factor that is just very common to all of us. We live in a forgetful generation, where everyone is busy. Everyone is occupied and preoccupied. So many things are taking up our time to the extent of not just forgetting God, but we even forget our own families. Parents have very minimal interaction with their children. And apparently this corona thing has given us an opportunity as parents to be with our children. We live in a generation where kids wake up at 5 a.m. in the morning, to go to school. And the same time, parents wake up early, they go to work, they come home late, either just before the children go to sleep or after the children have slept. And we honestly don't have time with our children. And we say we are busy. We say we don't have time. We live in a generation where the households have become the chief chefs of our family. They're the ones who prepare food for the children. They're the ones who prepare food even for us, because we don't have time. Fathers are no longer fathers. They've been reduced to sponsors, where they go, they hustle right after job, and they say, sinimeenda kuhustle nimeleta pesa nyumbani. What else do you want? So we live in a generation where fathers have reduced themselves to mere sponsors and they do not know anything about parenting. They have left the whole parenting issue to the mothers. That is the generation that we are in today. Our leaders are not any different. We elect them, expecting we will be served, but we beg for the essential services that we want. They are busy doing rounds in their constituencies, in their counties, but we do not feel exactly what they are doing. And when they go around, they make sure they take a good photo so that you know they were somewhere. But we don't feel them. Now, the sad thing about our leaders, our politicians, is that the constituents are suffering and their families are suffering because they are not at home to attend their families, neither are they down with the people. They say situation kwa ground is different, and it's true. We live in this situation. Even the same politicians have reduced themselves to the level of even branding their donations at this time that we need their help. They brand their donations as they give to the people in this era where we are suffering from COVID-19. That is the people that we are having. And today, I have a question for all of us. And the question is, what happens when the stone has been rolled away? The women asked, who will roll the stone for us? But today I'm asking, what happens when the stone has been rolled away? Today the whole nation is crying, the whole world is crying. But what happens when this is gone? Because it will surely come to pass. So my question today is, what happens after COVID-19? God has pressed what we call the reset button, where everyone has been restored to what I will call the default settings. But we need to ask ourselves, why? What does God want from us today? We have been forced back into our homes. For the first time in a long time, the children are enjoying more than 1 hour with their parents. For the first time in a long time. There was a joke that I read recently, and the child was asking, Mommy, kwani daddy amehama kuishi na sisi? Why? Because it's funny. They are not home. Until the kids are asking, kwani daddy amehama kuishi na sisi? Because for the kids, dads are not known to be home long, like what's happening right now. In fact, as if that was not enough, the government made sure that everyone is home by 7. Saa moja, wanasema tunaingia nyumbani na kuku. 7. Na wale wanaume wakujange home mapema, they are home by 7. So, this is a good time for us, as Christians, as the people who are watching us today, as the people who are listening to us today, as a church, to mend our broken families. Yes, we claimed we were busy, but God has given us a chance to be with our families. For those people who have not been in talking terms with their spouses, this is the right time that God has given us to mend the broken families. This is even the time that God has given us to know our children. Because honestly, we have not had time to know our kids. We have not had time to know what they are going through. They just go to school very early in the morning and we go to work. They come back in the evening and we come back later. And we have not interacted with these kids. But we all claim that we are professionals, we are working, and you know I'm supposed to go to work for my kids. But the question is, what happens when you worked for the kids? What happens when you have it all, then you use everything that you had to go and rehabilitate the same kids in our rehabilitation centers because they are lost in drugs, they are lost in alcohol, they are lost in addictions. Now, instead of the kids enjoying what we worked for, then we are using the same money to try to rehabilitate them to come back to normal. So this is a good time for families today. This is a good time for everyone to know their kids, to know their young people, and know what they are going through. So let us not just cry, oh, Corona, oh, COVID-19. No. We need to look at the bigger picture. What does God want us to do? And when we look at that, then we will know and we will fit into the purpose of God at this time. We are going to read in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 4, verse 9 to 13. Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 9 to 13. And it says, only be careful and watch yourselves closely so that you don't forget the things your eyes have seen, nor let them slip from your hearts as long as you live. Teach them to your children and their children after them. Remember the day you stood before the Lord your God at Horeb, when he said to me, assemble the people before me to hear my words, so that they may learn to revere me as long as they live in the land and may teach them to their children. You came near and stood at the foot of the mountain while it blazed with fire to the very heavens, with black clouds and deep darkness. Then the Lord spoke to you out of fire. You heard the sounds of words, but saw no form. There was only a voice. Bwana asifiwe. This was a reminder. It was like a lecture. And Moses was trying to make the children of Israel to remember where we have been, the battles that God had won for them. You see, the same people who God parted the sea for them, the same people who God rained manna from heaven, would dare complain to God when they found a difficulty. The same people where Moses had to raise their hand for them to win the battles were still complaining. And you see, they forgot that the same God who brought them from Egypt and parted the Red Sea was the same God who was there with them. But they would dare complain. And trust me, as a nation of Kenya, we've been through so many things. This is not the first thing that we are facing. We faced post-election violences. We faced massive corruptions. In our churches, we've seen the corrupt churches and the leaders of the church being found in some funny situations. And we forget about God. And I'm asking today, what happens when the stone has been rolled away? Because indeed, God will roll the stone because we are praying. But I believe there are many lessons that we need to learn. And then we are supposed to remember them. So the children of Israel forgot. And every time Moses reminded them. And we are no different. Because the things that God has done for us as a nation, as a church, we have forgotten. Indeed, we have forgotten. But this situation has brought us back to God. And today we are asking ourselves, where is God? But God is here and he will surely answer our prayers. John chapter 21 gives a story of disciples at the Sea of Tiberias. They had gone back to what they used to do. And when Christ appeared to them for the third time, they found them fishing in the lake. And it was funny because these guys have been followers of Christ every other day. They've walked with Christ. They've seen Christ perform miracles. And when Christ came to them, then they were fishing. It's sad because after this, some of us will go back to where we were. Some of us will behave like it never happened before. Some of our children will still feel that they don't have parents after this. Yet God has, for the first time, God has taken us back to our children. It's so sad that we can go back to fishing after God had, like the disciples, after Christ had died, resurrected, he found them doing what they used to do. So the question is, when this story is done, what are we going to be? Judges chapter 2, verse 9 to 10 says, then Joshua, son of Nun, the servant of the Lord, died at the age of 110. And they buried him in the territory of his inheritance in Timnah Heres, in the hill country of Ephraim, north of Mount Gash. All the generations were gathered to their fathers, and there arose a generation after whom who did not know the Lord, nor yet the work he has done for them. And my question today is, what kind of a generation are we raising today? Will our generation that we are raising today be like the generation that the Bible tells us today. And I don't blame the generation, but I blame the fathers who fathered that generation. Because it showed there was a link which somehow was missing between the fathers and this generation who did not know about God, neither did they know the work that God had done for the Israelites. And honestly, that is where we are. Because we don't teach our children. We just go to work, come back, go to work, and every other time. But you see, what will the children that we are raising be said of in the coming years? And we forget about God. And we forget about our families. And we forget about things that matters. And what are the dangers of forgetting God? Let me take you through a number of things that happens when we forget about God. Number one is rebellion. The children of Israel complained a lot. They wanted to go back to Egypt. They wanted to go back to Egypt. They forgot about what God had done for them, and they complained in their situation. They forgot the same God would do it for them at that point. And how different are we today? As a church of God, as a family, as a society, how different are we today? How much are we rebelling before God? Because indeed we forget. As a nation, we forget. We forget every day. So we rebel before God when we have forgotten about what God has done for us. Number two is that forgetting God makes us do foolish things. And that is very true. It's very true. You see, it's so easy for a man of today to forget how much investment they've done in their own families. And they will step out of their homes. They will find another lady somewhere. And they start building another family out there. Now, forgetting how much investment, how much it had taken them to build their families. So, you see, we need to learn lessons and know that when all things are said and done, trust me, saizi, hakuna mwanaume anaishi kwa mpango ya kando. Hakuna, kila mtu ako kwao. There is none. But you see, we will forget and we'll go back there. We will abandon our children. We will abandon our wives. Even wives will abandon their husbands when all this is done. And they'll go back to what they used to do. And you see, that is a foolish thing that I say. Forgetting God makes us do foolish things. How many foolish things do we do today? As a nation, after every 5 years, we elect the same leaders that we complain about right now. We elect the same leaders who, when they buy 10 bottles of sanitizers, they have to brand with their image. Wanaeka picha yao hapo. We forget. We forget. And after 5 years, in this nation, if you want to be elected so fast to be an MP or whichever political seat, you have to be. You do a criminal offense first. You have people behind your back saying, ni mtu wetu. And it gives you a platform to be elected as a leader. That is in our nation, and all of us, we know about that. But how fast are we forgetting this and making foolish decisions? How fast? Number three is that we make God angry. Psalms chapter 106, verse 21 to 23 says, they forgot the God who saved them, who had done great things in Egypt, miracles in the land of Ham, and awesome deeds by the Red Sea. So he said he would destroy them. Had not Moses, his chosen one, stood in the bridge before him to keep his wrath from destroying them? If it were not for Moses, God was angry with these people and he said, I will destroy them. But Moses stood in between them and God spared them. Who is standing between us today and our God? And this is where the church should be seen strongly. This is where the church should come out clear. This is where the church should speak in one voice and do what Moses did so that God would spare the children of Israel. And that is our position as a church today. The question is, who is standing on behalf of this nation of ours who is standing on behalf of Kenya at this time of need. And that is where our position as a church should be. Number four is that it leads to destruction. Forgetting about God surely leads to destructions. Psalms 50:22 says, consider this, who you forget God, or I will tear you to pieces with no one to rescue you. That's a firm warning. That's a firm warning. And God is warning us today that when the stone has been rolled away, if we forget, then he will tear us to pieces. So we need to look at what is the intention of God at this time of COVID-19. What is the intention of God? Ni nini Mungu anataka tujifundishe at this time? Because I know God surely has a reason for this time. And they said, experience is not like the best teacher, but the lessons that we pick out of the experience, that is the best. And I want us to see this in three forms. One, we will see it in family, in the church, and as a country. So what is the intention of God at this time of COVID-19? And let me start with the family, because that is where it all begins. When we have a functional family, we will have a functional society, and the nation will function well. But you see, we are crying about the top leadership of the nation, but they emanate from the family. When we have the correct values instilled in our children, then we will have a good society and we will have a good nation. And there is no one else to instill this in our children than us who are parenting these children. For the longest time, we left our children to the teachers in school, but God has made sure that we have these children back to us early. And for your information, saizi ni holiday, sasa official holiday for all the children. Ilianza last week. So, ndio ameanza holiday sasa. Ile ingine ilikuwa kionjo. And we don't know how long we are here. But this is the right time to set the right values for our children so that we can have a better society. Number one, the intention of God as a family is for us to work on our families and mend the broken pieces in our families. So what is that thing in your house, in your family, between you and your spouse that needs to be corrected? What is that thing between you and your children that needs to be corrected? What is that thing you've desired to do in your family and you've never done before because you've never had time, but right now you have time? What is that thing? So God has given us a golden opportunity today as families to deal with the issues in our families. Number two, God has shown us that we can be home by 7 p.m. Hata kama tuko busy aje. Yeah, when all is said and done, kila mtu ako home by 7. But we have people who have been so busy, they arrive at 2 p.m. No, 2 a.m. in the middle of the night. And they said, I was very busy. We've had people come home when the kids are asleep. Kila mtu amelala, anakuja kuamshana. Awamiwe chakula akule. We've had those people. But you see, God has his own way of dealing with these things. Everyone has to be home by 7 p.m. So after COVID-19, I hope and I pray that everyone will be home by 7. Because I believe that is one thing that we need to learn. With no excuses, the work is being done and everyone is home by 7. Number three is that we have been visitors to our children long enough. And it's time that we get to bond with our children. It's time that these children have a chance to know their father, to know their mom, to play around with them, to work with them, and to intentionally parent our children. As a family, I believe this is a desire of God, that during this time, we need to work on our families. Number two is the church. And as I said, the way Moses stood and the children of Israel were spared, this is the time for the church to come out strong and pray. And you see, we have been made as a church to realize And it reminds me of the sermon by our reverend just early this year, that it's time for us to move out of the building. And sure enough, we are out of the building. We all are out of the building. God has shown us as a church that we have been in the building long enough. And it was time, it was about time that we move out of the building. And that is what we are doing currently. We are out of the building. And we have been made to realize that the church is not the building, but the church is me and you. So where you are watching us from today, where you are listening to us from today, the question is, what is happening in that church that is you? From the time that you left the building, what has been happening? Did the word of God stop when you left the gates of the church, or the word of God is stronger than ever before? God has given us a chance to be the church out there and to intentionally lead our families to God. And that is what we need to do and to realize at this time of COVID-19. For the first time also, whether you have a very good, beautiful structure for a church, and whether you are worshiping under a tree, all of us have been equalized by this. Because God wanted to speak a message that it does not matter what structure you are worshiping me in, but when you are right with me, but when your heart is right with me, then that is all I desire. And everyone is working on himself or herself in their homes, because the church is not the building. The church is me and you. And what does God want us to know as a country? You see, God has proven that when all is said and done, he can make the world to come to a stop. And kuna watu wanakuanga na jokes wanasema, aki, dunia isimame nishuke. For your information, unaweza shuka sai, imesimama. So if you've been desiring dunia isimame ishuke, this is your time. Shuka tu, we are at standstill. Because God, when he decides to stop the world, he will stop the world. So as a country, we know, and we should know, that when all is said and done, God is supreme. God is powerful than any other science inventions, than any other superpower in this world. Because each and every nation right now is struggling to find a solution to this problem. It does not matter which nation we are speaking about, but God has shown that when all is said and done, even the best of scientists will take some time before they find a solution to this problem. Because I'm very sure the best, the most knowledgeable, the people in this world, the best of scientists would have sat and came out with a solution in 1 week. But how many months are we talking about this? It tells us God is supreme, way powerful than any other person, way powerful than any other nation. Number two is that the whole world is crying, and the whole world have been made to realize that at the end of the day, prayer is the best option. Prayer is the best option. And I know, and I'm sure, that each and every person in this world at this time, they've taken a moment to pray to God. And you see, prayer is the best tool to be able to fight whatever comes our way. And as a nation, we know this, that we need to pray as a nation, and we need to bring it before God. My point number three, and this one shocked me as a nation, where are our priorities as a nation? What is our priority as a nation? This is just a revelation that it was a funny one, because in a population of over 40 million Kenyans, 40 million Kenyans, with a budget of over 3 trillion shillings, we only have 518 ICU beds in Kenya. The whole nation. 518, the whole nation. And it was sad to know out of 518, over 440 beds are occupied. But we sing, Nimtuetu, 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 Nimtuetu. Where is our priorities as a nation? Every day when someone is accused of corruption, we come out fighting. But we see we are losing because even the whole nation, 518 beds in the whole nation, where are our priorities? This is the time that we need to learn as a nation that we need to establish the infrastructure that we have so that next time our people are well covered and well catered for. Number four, and my last point, is that before this thing happened, I don't know where we would be right now. I think probably we would be in the third album of reggae. No one knows. The whole nation was polarized, but right now we are at peace and we are asking God to continue giving us the peace, but also help us to sort out the issues that we have. Finally, Deuteronomy chapter 8 says, be careful to follow every command I am giving you today, so that you may live and increase and may enter and possess the land the Lord promised on oath to your ancestors. Remember how the Lord your God led you all the way in the wilderness for these 40 years to humble and test you in order to know what was in your heart, whether or not you would keep his commands. He humbled you, causing you to hunger and then feeding you with manna, which neither you nor your ancestors had known, to teach you that man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. Your clothes did not wear out, and your feet did not swell during these 40 years. Know then in your heart that as a man disciplines his son, so the Lord your God disciplines you. So let's take the discipline and let's pick the lessons and let's answer the question, what happens when the stone has been rolled away? God bless you. And as you do the interrogations in your heart and ask yourself what happens, then I pray that God will help you pick the lessons and learn the lessons. Thank you so much, and God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor. And indeed, what happens when the stone is rolled away? Do we go back to our normal life? Or is God giving us an opportunity to turn from our wickedness, to turn from our failings, and turn to him? Allow me to pray for you today that God would help you and me, that we would take the lessons and that we would learn from them. Father, we bless you. We thank you that when the stone was rolled away, we started a new life. You came that we could have that new life. But, oh Lord, how often we live as if you did not resurrect. How often we live as if you did not make the sacrifice on the cross. Have mercy upon us. Forgive us. And help us to be able to walk according to your ways so that your name is glorified. I bless you because I know that you have heard us. So, Lord, we submit ourselves to you. Change us and make us more like you. That's our desire. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We thank you for watching and for listening. Now it's our time to go into our Sunday school. And we ask that you go to our website and log in and get the Sunday school material appropriate for your child at every age. We love you. God bless you. See you again next week. And surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. God bless you.